May I now request Dr. Anita Ramesh to come forward and deliver her talk on approach to women with cancer.
Good afternoon, everybody. And I would like to thank the IMA organizing committee for inviting me for giving a talk on their IMA scheduled meeting. Today, we'll just go through an approach to women with cancer. We'll address some most couple of only the few important and the most prevalent cancers in women, like the breast cancer, cervical cancer, and the ovarian cancer, because these are commonly affected and there is a lot of mortality and morbidity attached to these cancers. Like heart disease, diabetes mellitus, and chronic renal disease, cancer is one of the leading causes of non-communicable disease declared by the WHO. Cancer is not a single disease. There are 100 types of cancer affecting different parts of the body. More than 70% of the cancer deaths usually occur in the middle and low income countries because of lack of proper resources, finance, medical care. And 40% of these can be prevented, mainly tobacco related, lifestyle related, and infection related. This is all over the world, a pictorial. As of 2005, 7.6 million people died yearly. Incident of the worldwide cancer, where the lung cancer, breast cancer, colon, and the stomach are the leading causes all over the world. Lung cancer in male, whereas in female, the breast cancer and colorectal cancer equally, and stomach equally in the all over the world. But there's a striking difference. We do not have a cervical cancer surge in the other parts of the world, which is one of the leading causes in India. Again, in developing countries, we see breast cancer, colorectal cancer, and in men, the commonest cancer is the oral cavity cancer and the upper aerodigestive tract cancer. And in women, cervical cancer is one of still the commonest cause of cancer in women, though with the westernized lifestyle, there is a now surge to the breast cancer, and we see a steep rise in the breast cancer and the fall in the cervical cancer incidence in India. Now, the top 10 killer cancers all over the world. So prevention and screening is one which will help us to give people a good quality of life. If we are able to screen them and pick them up at an early stage, they are curable. And many of these cancers are curable, like Hodgkin's lymphoma, non-Hodgkin's lymphoma, choriocarcinoma, early stage breast cancer, testicular tumor, germ cell tumor of the ovary, etc. Recent improvement in diagnosis and treatment for these patients have improved the survival figures because of lots of clinical trials conducted all over the world. But the scenario is a little different with our country due to several reasons, and there's late referral, delay in the treatment, and a non-availability of the treatment, and that's why we do get patients in the advanced cancer where palliative care becomes important in integral part. WHO has declared palliative care as a fundamental treatment should be given for all cancer patients in any tertiary cancer center. Now, we just quickly move into the women with cancer. Commonest, we will just discuss quickly these cancers. Commonest is the breast cancer occurring in the glandular portion of the breast tissue. Abnormal growth of cells. This is a picture of one of my patients who was treated. A breast has been removed and that area shows radiation reaction. So one of the main modalities of treatment in an advanced breast cancer is mastectomy. If patient comes early in T1, carcinoma and C2, we can do lumpectomy and keep the breast. And the incidence in Mumbai for these cancers is 27 cases per 100,000 women, where in the rural part it is still low as 8. So overall figure of over around 25 to 27 women per 100,000 women is diagnosed of cancer every year. Early detection helps to treat successfully. We must be aware of the symptoms. We should be able to pick it up early, and breast self-examination is one thing which should be disseminated among women of the reproductive age group, and they should do it monthly. Simple puckering, dimpling, retraction, these are the common abnormal signs and symptoms. And the common risk factors includes the hereditary BRCA1, BRCA2 genes. It is available. We can do it in India, but it is little expensive. Other risk factors are aging, genetic, family history, use of oral contraceptive pills, not having children or delayed birth of child, no breastfeeding, hormone replacement therapy, alcohol, fatty food, lack of diet, obesity, smoking, all contribute towards the formation of this cancer. This is a pictorial depicting lifestyle changes brings us to this type of cancer. If we can detect them before they reach this stage, that is the infiltrating cancer, we can save them and it is curable. Once it becomes infiltrating and it starts spreading into the blood vessels and metastasizes. The other varieties of cancer which we are not going to discuss today are cystosarcoma, inflammatory Paget's disease and cancer during pregnancy, which is very, very aggressive, and very few women can be saved if you detect to have this breast cancer during the pregnancy period. The clinical staging is the TNM. We will not get into details, but it is less than 2 centimeters, have a very good prognosis without node involvement, without any distant metastasis, and they are the low risks. If they are grade 1, less than 2 centimeters, no node involvement, no lymphovascular invasion, and ER positive, PR positive, HER2 negative. And as the tumor size, the pictorial diagram depicting how with the increase in the size of the tumor, your survival decreases because more is the chance of locally advanced disease and metastatic disease. The commonest method of screening as well as detecting is the mammogram. And also the self-breast examination, which I show you. And it will pick up scans with the early stage. And apart from the, and once any abnormality is detected in the mammogram, you need to do a biopsy. And a true cut biopsy, it's not an effinacy, it's a core biopsy, is what is the mandatory to diagnose or to rule out any missing out of the cancers. These cancers are usually treated by chemo, radiation, surgery. Surgery early stage is simple lumpectomy, advanced stage is radical mastectomy. Chemotherapy, if it is T2N0M0, we can avoid chemo and radiation. But once the more than 2 centimeters, lymph nodes are involved, lymphovascular invasion is present, perinodal invasion, grade 3, HER2 negative, ERPR negative, they are very aggressive. They need all 6 cycles to 8 cycles of chemotherapy as well as radiation and monoclonal antibody if somebody can afford. So total approach is a multidisciplinary approach. 3 kidneys to be in a specialized center where we can discuss in the tumor board individually each case and then deliver them treatment for these tumors. This is one of, these are some of the pictures of how advanced the breast cancer spread. This is the cutaneous involvement with the entire skin involved with the cancer cells. This is again retraction of the nipple once when she presented to us. This is a huge enlargement and that time she reported to us. So in India, even in the city of Chennai, we do see very, very advanced cancer. We see even cancers coming from rich family with fungating mass where they just don't tell their other family members because of social reason. There's another patient come. There's all black spots, subcutaneous involvement of the cancer involving up to the upper portion of the upper limb. And this is highly vascular tumor, starts spreading and it spreads to the lungs, bones, liver and brain, and the pictures that I have shown you are all incurable. They are all into palliative care, nothing. So the message is that before we reach that state, why don't we all work together for prevention, screening as well as early detection and treat them when they are at least stage 1, stage 2, when we can call them that breast cancer is a curable cancer. Again, these are some pictures of metastasis in the lung, metastasis in the brain. The patient who came to our emergency just with convulsions, done a CT, that was the picture. Later on, a clinical examination, we picked up a lump in the breast, which was undetected, presented. This is a local recurrence. She did her mastectomy, she didn't come back for her chemo and radiation. The multiple skin nodules at the site of the surgery. So we need to pass on the message to the media as well as to the patients who come from screening how to realize and recognize these early features of cancer. Breast self-examination should be taught. I just skipped through the slides. That is, it's look and feel, 2 things. Standing in front of the mirror and looking for abnormalities, hands up, hands down position. you start feeling in a circular fashion on all opposite breast, opposite hand with the opposite breast, both in the lying down, sitting and the standing position. Next screening method is ultrasound and digital mammogram, and that is to be done yearly, and a physician's examination is to be done yearly, and that's the recommendation for the WHO. Lifestyle changes leads to a healthier lifestyle. Avoid fatty diet, more fiber diet with fruits and supplements with antioxidants. Early detection, good exercise, avoid smoking and alcohol, and good diet. These are some of the messages for a healthy lifestyle, not only for breast cancer, this is applicable for any other cancer. And this is the recommendation worldwide how what to do about the breast cancer. Below the age of 40, we don't advise mammo, we say breast examination and physician's examination yearly. Another dreaded disease is the ovarian tumor. Ovarian tumor, usually they are present in advanced stage. You can't think of getting an ovarian tumor at stage 1, stage 2. They are all advanced with peritoneal disease when they present to us. Second common gynecological cancer after cervical cancer, and then one of the leading cause of death. 70% of the patients are in advanced stage. Even if you treat, more than half comes back, and the overall survival is still hovering around 30, and India is one of the cause and constituting about 5% of the cancers in women. There is a genetic BRCA1, BRCA2 association. It is the breast ovarian cancer syndrome. Particularly those who don't have children, they use fertility, that is in vitro fertilization, drugs, hormonal replacement therapy, family history are increased risks. Suddenly, patients usually present with abdominal distension, pain, loss of weight, loss of appetite, constipation, and when you do a scan, this is one of my patients who came, huge ascites. And the diagnosis is better towards a CT scan, preferably a CT is better, CA125 is the marker, and a tissue is needed before diagnosis, before we can start treatment. The CT scan of the woman with full ascites. Treatment of this, there's no role for radiation. Now, ovarian cancer, we don't need radiotherapy, but surgery, total abdominal hysterectomy, bilateral sulking, oophorectomy, lympharynectomy, peritoneal tissue dissection is what is needed for these patients, followed by chemotherapy, Taxol and platinum base, they are the standard of care. Now, we come to the commonest cancer, the cervical cancer, increased incidence for mortality. And it's the 7th common cancer in female and 8th common cause of death all over the world. But in India, it is the highest, and Tamil Nadu particularly sees large number of cervical cancer patients. These are the 100,000 women in near about Chennai. Human papilloma virus, an unidentified co-carcinogen, and the ectocervix is what is involved. The squamocolumnar junction is the area where dysplasia starts and gets into in situ cancer. There are three varieties of these cancer, and human papilloma virus is the commonest. Multiple sex partners, promiscuous partner, and early, younger the age of the first intercourse, and simplex virus, genital warts, cigarette smoking, contraceptive, intrauterine DES use, HIV, and early childbirth. Now, these are some of the things for our patients to delay the onset of sexual activity, know the sexual partner, have single partners, avoid smoking, and have sex, safe sex, and pap smear will come later. These are the carcinoma in situ can happen at the age of 30 and then 35 years and invasive cancer over, because it takes 10 to 15 years for these in situ lesions to become invasive. Other risk factors, avoid the HPV and the infection, and then pap smear. Pap smear again is to be done in the reproductive age group, and once in 2 to 3 years, or the recommendation said annually, and on our four patients to come and yearly, so once in 2 years. And they may present with abnormal bleeding in between periods, intercourse, after post-intercourse bleeding, after menopause, vaginal discharge, pelvic pain, and bleeding from the rectum. Physical examination, clinical examination, in if it is a carcinoma in situ, it may appear normal, but then we can do the dye test and then it becomes obvious. Exophytic growth, cauliflower line, intake, biopsy, CT scan is mandatory. And these are the stages. Stage 1, 2 is curable. Again, 3, Now, 3 onwards, it becomes little difficult to cure, and 4 is again metastatic disease. 1A, up to 1A you can do surgery. 1B, okay, plus minus, but then from stage 2 onwards, it is radiotherapy and chemotherapy is the treatment of choice for these cancers. Mortality and morbidity associated with regional spread of these cancers, particularly lymph nodes and to the other parts of the body, and particularly the ureter. We do see many patients having ureteral block by either by the mass or post radiotherapy, and they get into renal failure, uremia. And hematogenous spread is uncommon, but we do see patients with CNS disease, lung involvement. Now, the emerging evidence shows the human papilloma virus, particularly 6 and 11, with the delivery, detects the genital wall, but 16, 18, 31, 33 are the ones which are responsible for forming the dysplasia and this cancer. Pap smear, we can do a colposcopy, a cervical biopsy, and a pap smear should be done adequately to provide, to prevent enough of the infect, it should be done in a proper way, then only the yield is more, and it has to be quickly fixed to the specimen on the glass side. This is a pictorial showing how the normal cells changes with increased mitotic activity, altered nuclear cytoplasmic ratio, atypical nuclei, and first pap smear to be done when the patient becomes anybody sexually active or by the age of 18, yearly pap smear thereafter till the rest of their life. And if there's an abnormal pap smear and abnormal pap smear, then one has to refer to a gynecologist for further investigation. And this we skip these slides, how to do the pap smear. And the CIN is classified into 1, 2 and 3. And 1 and 2 you can do colonization, even up to 3 some people do colonization or cautery. But once it becomes stage 1 invasive cancer, you have to take the uterus out. These are some of the precursor lesions, are some intraepithelial lesions, but then you have to keep them under follow-up and do pap smear before they become aggressive cancer. Colposcopy examines and you'll be able to pick up the dysplasia. And this is normally the colposcopy is done. Cone biopsy is performed, and that always in our cancer, if you have to have a diagnosis, we need to have a biopsy. Without biopsy, you cannot treat a patient on a pap smear. So biopsy is mandatory. Regarding treatment, if it is early lesion, I told you cryo, colposcopic laser, excisional biopsy can be done, whereas all visible lesion has to be biopsied. If it is stage 1A, you can go to surgery, that is total abdominal hysterectomy, bilateral sulcing, oophorectomy. But once it becomes 2B and further, radiation and chemotherapy is the treatment of choice. Surgery, just that's what we discussed, and radiation is, I want to show you some slides of the radiotherapy, that's in it. Separate thing. So radiation, which is an external beam radiotherapy as well as internal radiotherapy. These are survival figures. Again, if you come in the stage 1, maybe early stage 2, that is 2A, we get around above 70% as a 5-year survival. But more advanced these stages, it is very quite difficult to cure. Few lines on cervical cancer vaccine. It has come into the market and it has been proven by FDA. Also, there was a study done in India that was done on Indian girls, but now the recommendation is yes, you can give it, there is no side effect associated with it. It can, if the recommendation says, you can start at the age of the first sexual intercourse. So that age may vary from country to country. We can give it from 9 years of age. And the upper limit, some say 26, but it can be given up to 45. But the effect of the vaccine decreases once you have been exposed to a sexual intercourse. So, because already you get infected and the protective function is not there. So, these are some of the girls 11 to 12 recommended age. And then.
It's alarm for you.
Okay. It's an alarm for you.
Okay. We are about to finish. And so, this can be passed on to the others, telling them that this can be prevented, particularly college-going girls before they get married. And this is just the support group. A cancer is a multimodal approach. We need lot of support from surgeons, radiation pathologists, medical oncologists, psychologists, and it is financial. We do have social support group because patient dropouts and all, and it's a huge, once patient gets diagnosed, it's a huge burden to the, and we have to break the things and get the whole family together and get them from. It's still one of the dreaded causes of disease. And training, educationing, not only all the entire community also has to be involved, even the medical professional, how to alert them, get them into the early stage, make them have the treatment. And then once the system is in place, we will be able to implement all of them. Just, I just show you two pictures, which is this is the True Beam latest machine which has come to Chennai. Just 2-3 slides about it. And it is now, over the period of time, radiotherapy has evolved. Initially, radiotherapy used to give not only good cell kill to the cancer cells, but it also used to kill the surrounding normal tissue. But now, with the advancement on the technology, we have rapid talk and True Beam, which gives only localized treatment to the tumor cells, avoiding the surrounding. These are different types of cancer treated all over the body, where you can avoid the spinal cord, avoid the important structures. And first in India was in HCG in Ahmedabad. In Chennai, we have one at Marriott. It has come. And HCG in our hospital in Alwar Bet, they have this machine which gives the rapid arc of the directed therapy to the tumor tissue without effect. And it's a very fast treatment and it doesn't irradiate the surrounding tissue. Thank you very much. I'm happy to take any questions. A transillumination, when you have the fluorescent dye, when you put the fluorescent dye and then with the illumination, that areas with dysplasia will pick up and have fluorescence, those cancer cells. So that is one of the methods, not correlated. That's one of the methods.
Okay.
Not usually.
Regarding the vaccination, you said there was a lot of arguments and debate in the parliament.
Yeah.
Has it been true?
Yeah, we have. There is an article published after all this debate. There was that this vaccine trial was done in Andhra Pradesh and Gujarat by Government of India, where thousands of young late girls, would rather to say, were exposed. But then there were, I think, total 7 deaths occurred due to the vaccine. That's the PATH study, PATH. And it was later on when I think BCG went and investigated the whole thing, it was found that all the 7 deaths was not related to the vaccine. One was a death to snake bite, one was death due to dysentery. And after that, BCG came with an approval revised saying, highlighting why these 7 deaths occurred when these girls following the vaccine. And it was not related to the vaccine, it was unrelated cause. So in India now it is marketed, it is approved by DCGI. 2 companies are making, one is Merck and the other, that is Gardasil and Services, the 2 names are there. And it is not yet in the National Cancer Control Program like we have BCG and polio, but it is open. If you want, you can take it. It's an approved vaccine.